Welcome back. Today we're going to work on some adorable fruit kawaii rocks, and we're going to use the lemon as our tutorial. So I'm starting out here using a chalk pencil to line out a lemon on the stone. So it's basically a football shape with some doodads on the end. That's my technical term, the doodads. And then the second one's going to be a lemon slice. Then from there, we're going to take some liquid white gesso and give a nice base coat to both of the stones, because yellow is one of those colors that's kind of tricky to get solid. So I want it to have a nice base coat so that the yellow paint will cooperate with us. So I'm going to start with this yellow paint, and I'm actually going to add some liquid gesso to the paint. So this helps with the opacity of the yellow paint. So I'm going to mix this up. And then I'm going to take a fine line paintbrush and start by putting the lemon rind on the lemon slice. And so in this video, you're going to see kind of how I bounce back and forth between two designs. Now we're going to bounce over to the lemon and give it a solid couple of coats of the yellow paint. So it'll take about two coats on this round to make sure that we've got a nice bright yellow lemon. What you can't see in the video is that the lemon slice is sitting off camera on my rock painting bench in front of a little desktop fan drying while I work on this rock. So that's kind of how I bounce back and forth when I'm working on more than one. I'm not going to let this one fully dry before I take this little spongy pouncer. It's by Martha Stewart. There's a link in the description, and a lighter yellow paint. And I'm just going to kind of get some paint on the pouncer and then dab it off on the paint palette, or you can use a paper towel, and then just kind of dab it into the lemon in the middle, kind of in the same football shape or oval shape, and then do the same thing with white paint. And I have a smaller version of this pouncer that I'm also going to use here around the edges, and just keep playing with it until you get the color combination that you want. Or just leave it a solid yellow. The solid yellow would look really cute too. Repurpose some of that paint by taking what white I had in the paint palette and moving it into the light yellow and mixing it up to lighten the yellow further. And this is going to go in the center of the lemon slice. This did take a couple of coats to get a nice solid light yellow in the center of the lemon slice, but it's well worth it. Coming back to our other lemon, I'm going to take a dotting tool and some white paint and just add some random dots off to the right side. Now bouncing back to the lemon slice, I'm taking a broad-tipped Posca paint pen to add that kind of rind detail to the lemon. So I did a line down the center and then two diagonal lines, and then I'm going to line around the rind and around the top with a little semicircle at the top. Now we're going to give these guys a little bit of personality with a 7mm Posca paint pen, and I'm going to do some of the kawaii eyes. So there are several variations. These are going to be kind of half moons that I'm going to add here, and then give them a little bit of eyelashes with a Sakura Pigma fine line paint pen for the eyelashes, because it's just a little bit finer and it's easy to kind of wisp it off. Yet another technical term, wisp. Wisp off the eyelashes, guys. Next, I'm going to take a dotting tool in this really light pink paint and add some little rosy cheeks to the lemon. Then I'm going to use a nail dotting tool, because it's rounded, to kind of swirl out the peaks in that pink paint. You can leave it like it is, or you can give it a border. I'm going to take that Sakura Pigma fine line pen and just give it a quick little border around, and you'll see down in that lower corner of the lemon, I made a little bit of an oops. And I'm gonna go back and fix that by just taking some of the bright yellow paint and kind of dabbing it on with a disposable eyeliner brush, which is really good for fine line detail. Coming back to the lemon slice, we're gonna add a different type of kawaii eyes. Using the dotting tool, just some plain round dots for the eyes, and then I'm gonna make an open mouth smile. Here come our rosy cheeks. And then I'm gonna swirl out those peaks and come back with a white dot, a larger dot, and then one smaller dot to give those eyes. And now I'm going to take a red paint pen to create the tongue and then fill in that background with the black. So we have kind of an open mouth, giggle, or laughing little lemon slice. You know me and my glitter paint. I'm going to take some of this Folk Art Extreme Hologram glitter paint and a large dotting tool. And this is kind of a dot and drag technique. And it's going to give the appearance of like squirting juice, like lemon juice squirting off the side. And I'm going to add it to both the lemon slice and the lemon. This is kind of a subtle detail because it's going on to the bare stone without any outlines or anything. But when you get resin on it, it really kind of helps it pop. So I'm also adding a little bit of sparkle to the dots on the full size lemon. And then here's our little juice squeeze accent detail. So you can play around with the color in this design and you end up with a grapefruit, a lime, or an orange. They are so much fun, they're easy to do, and the little kawaii eyes and faces just bring them to life. Thanks for stopping by to watch, and I'll see you next time.